Hey YouTube, Hill Country Husker. Sitting here waiting to pick up the kids from school. Thought I'd make a quick video, just kind of talk about a little bit about me and specifically what prompted me to get into the prepper mindset, or you know, what led me to kind of where I am today. Fortunately, I have a job that allows me to have the opportunity to pick the kids up from school at least once a week, sometimes twice. Sometimes I get to drop them off in the mornings, pick them up in the afternoon. So that's good. I think it's important that you're involved in your kids' life. I got four kids, so I try to be involved in what they do. I know the wife appreciates it. Normally she picks them up from school, drops them off. So this kind of gives them a little bit of a break. Got four kids, three different schools, so it's sometimes in the afternoons and mornings it can be hectic. So I'm glad to be able to help out with that. And of course, it's always fun to come to the school parking lots and see all the craziness that goes on with the way people drive and the way, you know. Anyway, not going to get into all that. Oh. What gets somebody into the mode of preparing? That's really the topic here. I know a lot of people, from what I've seen on the different, like the doomsday shows that you see on television and such, that a lot of people have traumatic events in their life, or they experience natural disasters or man-made disasters. You know, whether it be something as traumatic as what happened on 9/11, or something similar to the hurricanes that occur on the Gulf Coast, like Ike and Katrina and such. You know, those are good examples of where people have failed to prepare. Fortunately, I've never had to be in a situation like that where I've experienced a traumatic event like that, but. You know, when I was younger, I was maybe more liberal-minded, more, you know, always kind of believe the old saying that if you're not a liberal when you're younger, you don't have a heart. If you're not a conservative when you get older, you don't have a brain. You know, I used to have the Greenpeace stickers and stop apartheid and all that, but of course I've always voted conservative. You know, I consider myself a Reagan conservative. First time I was able to vote, I did vote for Ronald Reagan back in the 80s. I'm not ashamed to say it. I still vote along the conservative lines. You know, you might see my Ron Paul sticker there in the back. I like a lot of what the libertarian plank stands for. I don't think Ron Paul has a chance, but I like a lot of what Dr. Paul says. So with that, anyway, what got me into prepping? I think basically, you know, I went through Y2K, laughed it off, didn't think much of it, didn't think there'd be much of an event, and it turned out that it wasn't much of an event. It was just another happy new year, and things clicked right along. And thought it was funny to see all the after Y2K, all the surplus water barrels and everything that were for sale at cut rate prices. What really got me thinking about preparing for bad times happened in 2008, of course, after the election. And I had never felt as bad. I had never felt such a sickening feeling in my gut, fearful of what path the country might be going down. The thought of having a progressive socialist in the highest office in the country just really scared the daylights out of me. And shortly after that, got me in the mode. Now I'm not a big advocate of something like a polar shift or, you know, coronal mass ejection. I don't think really that Iran's going to drop nuclear bombs on the U.S. I may be wrong. I'm not preparing for, you know, I don't have a bunker stocked full of, you know, chemical and biological suits with respirators, and I'm not stockpiling iodine and stuff like that. I think I'm more practical. I'm basically looking at a economic collapse of the country, which I think that's more likely to happen. And you know, I try to be practical in it. You know, we're setting back food supplies, equipment, you know, things that, you know, when times get bad economically, I think we're going to be more prepared. I'm fortunate that my wife has a similar mindset, and we work together on what we're doing, setting aside and being able to prepare for that. So, you know, that way, I don't know what the exact date and time of when I got into this mindset, but sure did have some regrets when I did, that I didn't start a whole lot sooner. Looking back on the times of plenty when I could have been setting more back and didn't, and now I'm trying to play catch up, whether it be in stockpiling food, equipment, ammunition, weapons, bug out locations, if you will. I'm a little bit behind the curve on that, trying to make up for lost time. I think we're doing good. I think we're better than most. I do have some acquaintances that are of a similar mindset as I am and as my family is. So I think we're okay. I think we're getting there. But anyway, it's just a little bit about me and what got me to where I kind of am now. And hopefully through these videos, I can learn from the community out here on YouTube, and if I'm lucky, I might be able to help somebody else and pass on some information, maybe get some people to thinking. And if I can just do that and grow in what I need to know and pass on some information, I think everything will be good. So with that, just want to pass this on and be talking about some other topics here in the future. I'd like to talk a little bit about risk management here in some future videos and some other things I've got on my mind, and I appreciate you guys checking it out. That's it. Have a good one.